Hey, what's up, everybody? This is Nico Wright from College Court Report, and I'm here at the London Lightning head office in London, Ontario, to interview former LIU Brooklyn Blackbird star, Julian Boyd. Okay. What's up, everybody? I'm here with Julian Boyd, former LIU Brooklyn star and current London Lightning champion for the National Basketball League of Canada. How you doing, Julian?
Not too bad, man. What's up, man?
Good to hear. Now, let's just start here. Let's talk about your time at LIU. Walk me through what was recruitment like for you when you were going out of high school, coming out of high school.
Well, I mean, the crazy thing is probably after, like, the career I had at LA, it was kind of hard. I really only was recruited by five schools. Okay. And there was Liberty, San Houston State, Texas State, UC Riverside, and LIU Brooklyn.
Okay.
So at the time, probably one of the funnest parts about going into college and beyond is taking the visits. Your official visits to schools are amazing because you go, you get to eat as much as you want. They're trying to, they're impressed you to go. So, you know, it's a fun time. Kind of like, I guess, how NBA players want to go to a different team, they'll flip around shop. But that's kind of what it was. When I went to LIU, I took my visit. And up there, I was right by the lights. The lights got me. Yeah. Times Square, all that. It was, you know, I'm from Texas. Not saying it's a tiny little farm town or anything. You know, we have stuff, but I've always been the type to want to be in big cities and stuff like that. So once that visit came, I got there. They got me.
And as a freshman coming to LIU, were you promised like playing time? Were you gonna start? What was the plan for you while you were going there?
That's funny. None of that. It was, you know, we want you. We think you'd be good. Want you to come in and obviously play well. I never got promised playing time. Never, none of that. Just come in and work hard, and basically whatever happens. So I've always been the type to work hard. You know, I've always, if I'm put in a position, I'm gonna be the best I can be in that position. So after getting that and stuff, it was definitely, I wouldn't say a shock, but definitely do a lot more in college than you do in high school. You know, having to be on workouts at this time, go weights, and then go to be on the court. You have defensive time, practice, not no basketball, just defense, and then we'll have bigs or, you know, guards. Like, so it's a whole same thing, basketball, playing basketball, but same, just your time is more. You have to be on time or knowing what you have to do. Yeah, definitely more routine. Great words, exactly.
And did you expect that coming out of high school? Did you know that that's what you're getting into? Like,
I wouldn't say I expected it, but I would say, like, I kind of thought it was going to come, so I tried to put myself in that mindset. This is what it's going to have to be. So even if it wasn't like that, I would have already been prepared like that. It would have been easy. So I kind of, I tried to get prepared knowing it wasn't going to be like high school.
And so at LIU, what's like your best part, or what's like your fondest memory of playing days in college?
Man, well, the best is probably going to the NCAA tournament. We, you know, were blessed to be able to go three times in a row, which was amazing being there. But probably individual moment, one time I'll never forget. It's kind of a good bad moment, but it was my freshman year. I got there. We were doing well. I was having a good season. We made it into the playoffs. We got in the playoffs. And our first game was against a good team at the time in Quinnipiac.
Okay.
They had some good players at the time then. And we were definitely the underdog in that game at the time. We weren't up to the LIU we were after a few years. So we came in, we was down 16 points with 5 minutes left to go. We came all the way back. It was the last second play, like 2 seconds left. I wasn't supposed to touch the ball on this play. Literally was not supposed to touch the ball. I walk out on the court, one of my seniors, I was really cool to Ron Manigault at the time. He came to me and he said, "Don't set the screen," he said, "pop up." That's all I said to me. I said, "Wait, what is it? Just pop up." I said, "All right." We run the play. My man literally sets a moving screen on this guy, pushes him down the free throw line. I pop up to three, I hit the three, and we go into overtime. So it's crazy, that wasn't even supposed to be the play. Our senior changed the play and trusted me as a freshman, and I shot three threes on the season.
Yeah.
Three, four, no, I shot zero threes on the season. That's my only three. First and only three on the season my freshman year.
That's wild.
Never shot one, said, "Shoot." So, all right, we made it with overtime. Sad part is we ended up losing the game, unfortunately. So, but that memory, that, like, it was just cool to be able to be on the court. No one knows that's not what was supposed to happen. No one knows I wasn't even supposed to touch the ball, but it was cool. I hit the shot, and then we ended up losing. But I think that just built for basically fire and energy coming back down, knowing I can play. Like, I think that's one of the biggest things is knowing I can play there. Like, I got there, and it's like, all right, how am I going to play? How am I going to be? But then when I get there, once you get in that comfortability spot, it's definitely a lot better. So, like, I was comfortable playing. I knew I could play. We lost in the playoffs. Like, I want to get back. And then from then on, quite a few things happened. But we definitely started winning, and it was a great time.
Speaking of that shot, it brings you back to that time against Orangeville, where, you know, the fourth quarter was rough for us.
Yes, it was very rough.
We needed a bucket and a little bit of rise action with you, and the same kind of story happened there. You got a shot in three.
It's crazy that happened too. Honestly, it's one of my favorite plays we have when I rise up. I'm usually always open, but at the time, Doug Heron was on the floor. It was great eyes, great IQ of basketball. He could have taken it all the way to the rim, got a bucket, we still would have been okay, but he found me, and I just feel like, if you're wide open, you should hit the shot.
Yeah, sure.
Obviously, it doesn't happen all the time, but you should hit it. Exactly. Thankfully, that time I hit that, and that was basically a good little ice closer there, and we ended that game up.
And were you always a shooter? Like, because you have athleticism, that's not even questionable, but like, were you always a shooter, or did you have to really work on that?
So the funny thing is, no, I wasn't, not at all. In high school, my senior year, I shot 12 threes. I made six of them, so I shot 50%. I'll go with that. When I talk about it, I shot 50% my senior year. But then, like I said, my freshman year in college, I didn't shoot 1 3 until that playoff game. So it was like, in my mind, I knew I could shoot it, but that just wasn't really my role at the time on the teams I was at. And I just feel like always play your role, do what you're supposed to do. Like, even if I can, I want to be out there shooting threes all the time when I can get points down low and rebound and stuff. So it worked out well. And then after my freshman year, that's when my coach was like, I want you to start shooting. Like, okay, it's time for you to do that. So then I started working on it more. And then since then, I'm an elite shooter now. now I'm an elite.
Yeah, you can shoot for sure. And then do you have any like pregame rituals that you did while you were at LIU?
Really?
Like tie your shoes?
Nothing really crazy. There was times I'd feel like maybe go to the bathroom. Honestly, that's it. I needed to always go to the bathroom before the game. Mm-hmm. Just as long as I'm good, I know I'm good to go. But like now, not really even much like that anymore. I might here and there, but it's not like a thing at all. I got to do this to have a good game now. So now it's just kind of going there with the flow of the game. You know, get ready.
Just have your mind ready.
Exactly. That's why that's the most important thing.
And then so going from there to like you went to Finland after you got to LIU.
I did, but what had happened was I finished and I tore my ACL for the third time when I was there. So after I tore it, I was pretty much done. I was like, I can't play anymore. I got lucky. I got to have surgery one more time, and I got to stay in New York for a few months after, and I was doing rehab there. And then I came back home into, which is Texas. I was in San Antonio working out with my trainer at the time for the next year and a half. I was just there at home, not doing nothing, just working out. I worked at a gas station. I worked a few regular jobs at the time, just trying to, in my mind, get back to basketball. I knew that's what I wanted to get back to. So after a long year and a half out of not playing and stuff, I got blessed with the opportunity. It's funny, the coach of that team in Finland actually played at LIU Brooklyn. That's how he knew me, which is crazy. Yeah, so he hit up my coach at the time, who I hadn't seen for a while because I was home anyway, but he contacted me one day and said, there's a team in Finland that's interested in you. Like, how do you feel about playing there? And gave me his contact information and stuff. We started talking a little bit, and then I just basically gave him an opportunity to play. I want to come back, and they gave me that opportunity, so I went out to Finland. I got to play. I did very well. Us as a team, we did better than they did the year before. Still not great, but it was a stepping stone, I feel like. So, and it was for me to be able to get back on the court. You know, I had that confidence back. I could still play. I could play with people like this, and I'm still here. So that was it was definitely a great experience out there. Really cold. Very cold, a lot of snow, but for the first time in my life, and only time I saw the Northern Lights, and by far, if anybody in their life can see it, I would pay to go see them again. Like, that's how crazy it is. Yeah, so that was definitely a great experience to be able to be there, play, get back on the court, and then thankfully I got blessed with another opportunity to play again, which was here in Finland.
And now compare Finland to Canada as far as the winterness.
Mm.
How would you compare the two?
Well, I heard I caught Canada on a not bad winter this year, which was still bad to me.
Yeah.
But I'd have to say the amount of snow in Finland was crazy. That's the most snow I've ever seen in my life. But as far as coldness, Both are extremely cold to me, and anything under, you know, you guys use Celsius, so anything under whatever, I feel like y'all would say is zero. How cold is that? Is that extra freezing?
That's zero. That's just like
just regular zero. Oh, wait, like it's still warm?
That's like zero's fine. It's when you get negatives.
All right, negative zero Fahrenheit, I'll go with it. Okay. Negative 32 Celsius.
It doesn't get
that
here right now, but
like, all right.
We're like negative 20, negative
15. Okay, yeah, around there. That's too cold for me. Yeah. Anything that says negative,
that's
too cold. That's too cold.
And then, so tell me more about you still calling your third ACL injury. So speak on how that happened and when it happened.
Well, so what happened was I was trying to rush back a little bit in college because it was my senior year.
Yeah.
So I was like, this is it. Like, regardless of what's going to happen, I want to play. I want to finish off playing. So I was about 5 months in. I was literally about a week and a half away from coming back. And we was in Texas again at the time. The first time I tore was in Texas, which is funny now. So we was in Texas. We was doing practice. I was practicing just a regular drill. I dribbled down, went to go pass out. I turned and it tore, and as soon as it happened, I knew it happened.
Yeah.
So I was definitely angry. I was like, this is it, I don't know, I'm done. Yeah. So basically at the time, I got blessed, like I said, the school I was at, they kept me there, they allowed me to get surgery again, and I got to do the first months of rehab, which is like the hardest part there with them. So definitely took care of me on that. And it was just, at the time, it's really down and all that, you know, I could have, like it's over, not trying to do anything, just in my mind, like it's done. But there's some part of me that's just like, you still can't stop.
Yeah.
Like, you're still, I feel like if you're meant, like, if you feel like you're meant to do something, like that feeling just won't go away. So, like, if I were to stop it, but I gotta go back and do this because there's something there that's just going to do it.
Yeah, for sure.
So, I definitely feel like it's something that helped me get to this point now to be able to still be playing after going through it. It's just, when you're meant to do something, like that's what you need to do, or at least go as hard as you can until it's literally not possible anymore.
And that speaks to your mentality on game days, right? Like, you gotta go.
Bro, that's it. 100%. Once game day comes, you walk in the locker room, you walk on that court, it's business time. Go out there, play as hard as you can every day, because as I've found out, you know, everyone says you don't know when your last game will be, but I've experienced that quite a few times now, what could have been my last game, and it's not a great feeling at all. So that's why every time you're out there, if it does happen, at least I know I'm out there. There's nothing more I could have did. Literally not a little bit more I could have did.
So, before we move on, I don't know, Pat Julian's ego. got some stats here.
Let's see how I did.
His freshman season at LIU, Julian Boyd averaged 10.5 points per game and 6.4 rebounds and got Rookie of the Year honors. Sophomore season. Bumped up a big, got 13 points per game, 8.9 rebounds, and you played in the NCAA tournament against Tar Heels, lost in the second round.
First round. Well, the first round is technically what they call a play-in round. Right. And all that. So second round, yes.
Yeah. Talking about that game.
Oh, man, speaking about that game, they had a lot of big names on that team.
That was a big year for them.
That was a huge year for them. They
2012, right?
Harrison Barnes, 2012. Yeah. Harrison Barnes, Tyler Zeller, Kendall Marshall. John Henson.
Mm-hmm.
I think they had Ed Davis at the time.
Probably.
I think they had Ed Davis still. But basically, they had a stacked NBA team.
Yeah.
For sure.
Okay.
Who
were you guarding?
At the time, I was guarding Tyler Zeller.
Okay.
Yeah,
okay.
So a little size difference there, just a little bit. But I feel like we played well. We stuck in there well. We was tied with 2 minutes left, 3 minutes left in the first half until they wanted to go on a 2 minute, like 12 point run and went down about 12 at halftime there. But I just feel like going back to the confidence thing I was talking about, like when you're on a court with other people that are superior to you or better than you, like you want to go out and be like, I can play with these people. So, like going out and be able to play that game at 18 and 12, I think, like after doing that, it's like I can play with these people. And I feel like that's a lot of people's problem. Like, I've met so many people who I see can play the game of basketball, they're good, but they don't have it to where, like, they feel like they're not good enough to go and do what they do.
And we'll toughness.
Yeah, exactly. And I feel like that's one of the biggest things. You have to have confidence in yourself to be able to go. Even if you feel unsure, like I was, like, so when I went to college, I wasn't sure how I'm going to play with these guys. When you get to the tournament, you're there, you're like, oh, how am I going to play with these guys? But you go out and just play, know how you usually play, it lets you settle down and just play. So
sure.
It was definitely a great, great experience to get to them, even though it didn't turn out too well.
Hey, well, you came back for your junior season, and speaking of, you know, mental toughness and trying to be stand out amongst pros, he came back with vengeance. He got 17.4 points per game that year and 9.3 rebounds. He was killing it.
And he hit that 10, man, 0.7 away.
NEC Tournament MVP, first team All-NEC, and Northeast Conference Player of the Year honors.
That was a good year.
That was a very good year. Killing it.
Yeah, and then I just feel like it's, like you said, one thing you want to get better at every year or two. So even if you look at your stats from the year before, it's, I need to be higher and every last one of these just shows I worked, I got better, this and that. So that year coming back, it's funny, it was me and another player on my team named Jamal Lossower, who was a very, very good player in his own right. And literally that MVP and that Player of the Year award literally could have went to either of us that year. Quick little funny story. My coach at the time, he brought me and Jamal into the office one time. It was towards the end of the year when they were about to start giving out awards and stuff. And he told us, he said, one of you is going to get Player of the Year. He's like, it's inevitable. It's going to happen. I just don't know who. And I don't want one of you to feel upset about if the other one gets it or not. And thankfully, both of us as people were happy for each other if it happened. Yeah. So it's not like we had anyone on the team saying, oh, if he gets it, shouldn't have got it. We were happy for each other. We were in there like, yeah, it's literally the last problem we're worried about in here. It was like, hey, if they want to give both of us, we'll do a co-player of the year for the first time ever and call it that. Like, it'll be cool. But, yeah, so I got lucky. Like I said, I did very well, but our whole team around us was doing very well, too.
Sure.
I just got lucky that my numbers were where they were, and they chose me for that. But it's even better being able to go to the second year of the NCAA tournament and then play Michigan State that year.
Yeah.
Which is actually pretty fun. They had Draymond Green at the time. They had a very good point guard. Was it Page? No. Forgot his name. But they were very good.
Senior, yeah.
They were very good. That was another good experience to have. I should say. You know, it's great to be able to play with those caliber guys in an arena full of 15,000 people in there. It's definitely exhilarating and something you'll never forget ever.
Sure. And then moving forward as well, like now you're playing in Canada for Lund Lightning. You're back for a second season. We have him right now.
Yep.
When do you see the court?
My goal is February, late January, mid February, to be back on the court full playing again and stuff. As of now, I'm about 5 months into rehab, so I still got a little more time, but like I'm feeling strong. People with Fowler can take care of me very well. I feel like I'm going to die every day sometimes from the work that they put me through, but I know once I step back on that court, it'll all be worth it, not having to be tired, not being in shape, being in everything. So it's been tough being out again, having the game take away again, but like I said, going back to feel like you're meant to do something until you can't no more. I feel like you just gotta go. So I feel like I'm good. The knee feels good, and now it's all about just getting it fully right, getting it fully healthy, and getting back on the court and showing again that I can still play.
Sure. One more college question before we get out of here. What was the school that you always looked forward to playing to in your years of playing at LIU? Like, who did you always like get, I say, pumped up for, or knew that you're gonna have a good game against?
Well, saying that, in our conference there's a school called Fairleigh Dickinson, and that was a team every time. My stats, probably, if you looked at it, that game would be ridiculous every time.
Yeah.
And I don't know what it was. It wasn't like the players on the team. It wasn't like, I don't know why or what it is. And I think about it too, even when I watch NBA, how they average this amount against this team. Like, this team is good. Like, why do you do that? I guess that was just my time. Came and it was like, it's my time. That's how I felt with Niagara this year. Like,
yeah, for sure.
Like, that's how I felt. It's like, you come against this team sometimes, it's just going to be your time, regardless.
Yeah.
So But one game that I got super pumped up for to actually play in one time, it was play Kentucky at Rupp Arena. Ooh. So that was a game I was super excited
for. Who's on that Kentucky team?
We had Alex Poitras, Nerlens Noel. They had Archie Goodwin, who almost had a triple double against us. One assist away from a triple double. There was another guy. Wish I could remember right now. But yeah, the team was pretty stacked. They were pretty good. But being played in Rupp Arena. Have those fans that even though they weren't for us, it's just like I said, it's like an NCAA tournament feel. And you're there around that many people just in the arena being able to play. Yeah, it's a great feeling, man. I love it.
Is that the only time you ever played them?
Yeah, that is the only time we ever played them. But like we have played a few good schools. We played them, we played Maryland, we played who else we go against in the preseason. We had another big game my senior year. Kentucky, though, is definitely, like, the biggest school we play in, just environment, or, like, their gym is in a mall.
Really?
But yeah. You gotta go through the mall to get to the gym.
Is it on, like, near campus, too, or?
Honestly, I don't know what wasn't campus when I was there. So we might have been on campus, but it looks like you're in the regular city.
That's crazy.
So, yeah, it's definitely, it was a crazy experience, crazy school to be able to go and play against, and especially such a historic program in basketball, too. It was definitely great.
I'm happy here. Thank you for taking time to share with me, Julian.
Nah, thank you, man. I appreciate being on here.
All the best in recovery and have a good season, all right?
Yes, sir.
All right, that's College Court Report. I'm Nico Wright, signing off.